Researchers around the world are testing the effectiveness of several coronavirus vaccines. Health experts still haven't approved one for use here in the U.S., but they are getting closer. Dr. Maria Simbra takes a look at how things are progressing.
With coronavirus treatments and vaccines, drug companies push ahead and pull back.
Eli Lilly is putting its monoclonal antibody treatment trial on pause due to an unspecified safety concern.
If it was mimicking the symptoms of the actual virus too much, or it was having an overly robust reaction.
An independent review board will examine the data. Just last week, Eli Lilly asked the FDA for emergency use authorization for this therapy, a manufactured immune system protein to neutralize the coronavirus. It's a competitor of Regeneron's antibody cocktail the president received. Regeneron has also applied for emergency use authorization for its product. This comes just a day after Johnson & Johnson interrupted its late-stage vaccine trial because of an unexplained illness in a study participant.
This is basically just good science and careful science, and we need to proceed with caution anytime we develop a new vaccine.
In September, AstraZeneca temporarily stopped its vaccine trial due to a case of spinal cord inflammation.
I would anticipate that one of these trials is going to stop and some of them are going to continue. That's just the nature of introducing a new vaccine through research.
Pfizer plans to include children as young as 12 in its vaccine study.
I think it's absolutely necessary. We're not going to give this vaccine to children after we've only tested it on adults.
The FDA has approved the plans. While severe COVID is rare in children, they can pass the virus to high-risk groups.
Children have sometimes less intense reactions, and sometimes will have more intense reactions.
Pfizer will enroll younger children based on safety data in teens and young adults.
Typically, new vaccines and treatments take years and decades to develop, but with COVID, we're talking about months. Stops and starts are inevitable and should be reassuring. It's all part of the safety process. I'm Dr. Maria Simbra, KDKA News.